Hi, this is Freddie, and today I wanted to talk to you all about the tack and bend method of making art out of steel. Please comment and rate. I say this every time, but I think it really helps. Here is all you need to do this: a torch, the safety equipment, and the material. That's all you need besides the gas. You can have other stuff would help, but this is all you really need. Let me just get to the basics of bending. Okay. So if you want a straight 90 degree bend, you concentrate all your heat in one place and then you pull it and it makes a nice tight bend. Hardly ever do I use a tight bend when I'm making sculptures. Usually what I do is I make long, curved, irregular bends. And the way to do that is you get your heat stripe, that's the little part that's glowing, and you make it wider than the tight bend, and you move it, you move the part that's glowing the most is where it's going to bend the most. You move that part up and down as needed and then give it a little pressure. Once you get to the end, the metal that you just came from is still pretty hot, so you can just go back and over it, back and forth over it, and then just bend it until it takes the shape you want. And eventually you'll get the hang of it. And we'll be able to judge where it's going to go. This is a thicker rod than I usually use for this method. I just wanted to show you all bending. Okay, so as you can see here, the bend on the left is straight and the bend on the right is more open. You can use your welding torch to cut the rods as you're going. Just melt it off and rip it, that's all. Okay, so here I'm going to draw an arm, and The principle here is simple. Imagine you have a three-dimensional arm and then you get tape or something and you wrap it around the arm, but not everywhere, just certain places where you can accentuate the muscles, between where muscles would be or whatever. And then you just wrap the metal around where your imaginary arm is, and then you weld up all those little strands, and it makes a nice fluid dynamic, you know, piece with a cool designs, and it looks really neat. But you don't have to weld every single inch, and it saves a lot of time working because you can see the negative space as well as the space with the rod. Okay, the hardest part for me usually is starting, so what I found out is just start, and you can always change it later. Kind of like with drawing, like some of the best drawings I ever did started off with just a scribble. But here I'm just trying to get like the forearm shape made, and I'm just doing the basic, you know, just one little line to start with. And I like to make my stuff a little bit, you know, like superhero proportioned. So I'm making a big fat forearm. And okay, I did the two dimensionally. Here I'm making it so that it wraps around. So it's not just squiggly from looking on sideways, but if you look down it's actually spiraling around where the forearm would be. So it's like a bracer covering where the arm would be, but not everywhere. It's kind of hard to explain it, but you'll see at the end. Okay, Tom Gingrass came up with the term tack and bend, as far as I know. He teaches it in school. And Daniel Keeper does it too. He has those sculptures on my channel, Daniel Keeper. You can look it up. He does this method as well. And once you get one down, you just keep putting them down like next to each other or just flowing around where the other ones are, and just make sure that you have it wrapped around lengthwise as well as, you know, widthwise, so it's really going around and spiraling around where the arm would be. If that makes any sense. You can save a lot of time and energy if you pre-bend the rods before you stick them in there, like on your table or something. Just give it the basic shape of what you're going to want it and then weld it in. If you're not going to do that, there's ways to make it fit, like you bend it above where it's going to go, that way it'll fit in, and then you just lay it out. See, this looks kind of, it doesn't look like much now, but it'll look cool later on. And you see, there's where I'm talking about wrapping it, spiraling it around it. See, this is going to be the forearm. That little round part at the end, I'm going to cut that off. I was picturing that being the wrist, but then I decided to make the wrist a lot skinnier. So that's going to go. Here I'm doing the bicep. Again, I'm not doing the whole bicep, just a few lines here and there to give it, you know, the impression that there's some stuff where the empty spaces are. In this video, I'm showing you how to do it with only the torch. But if I was going to do this for myself, all these little tacks that I'm doing here, I would use the MIG for that, because it would save a lot of time, a lot of energy, and a lot of gas. Money. It would save money. But it doesn't. This number one tip that I'm using here hardly takes any gas, so I'm not really worried about it. And I need to use up this gas because I'm switching over to propane and MIG for this kind of stuff. Although acetylene is better to use because when you weld these things up, you have like ultimate control of your welds with the oxyfuel. Whereas MIG, if you do it wrong, then you're gonna have to do some grinding. Here, you can't really do it wrong. Okay, so here I'm working on the shoulder, and I want it to be kind of muscular. And I'm just putting rods pretty much wherever I feel like it. I'm not going on any specific design here, even though I drew that picture just to show you the concept. It's a lot easier to just do it. Working from a picture in this method is very difficult. Okay, so in case you didn't realize, this is all sped up just to keep you all watching it, because it'd be very boring without. Like I said, this method is takes a lot more time, but it's really fun. So if it's fun, then time doesn't matter. And here I'm putting the bicep in. I'm really trying my hardest to put a minimal amount of stuff in because the way I think, I want to fill it all in, but I'm going to try just to keep it minimal. And here I'm welding in the bicep. And this is just one video. I'm gonna do a bunch of videos on this subject because there's a lot to talk about, a lot of little tricks and stuff. So keep an eye out, because this one's just pretty much just a basic overview of this method. See, once they're all welded up together, then it looks like a fluid piece. It looks really cool. So stay tuned, because I'm working on this is just not even a part one. This is just like I'm trying to do a whole long video of only this process, and I'll have it done in like a week or so, but it'll be like everything that I know I'm going to show. So stay tuned for that, and I'll finish this guy up on that video complete. Don't forget to leave a comment and rate the video, please. Please, I beg you, rate the video, even if it's a thumbs down. I think that the ratings help. And you know what? Leave a comment, just say whatever. It doesn't have to make sense. I think the comments help too. Come on, help a brother out.